So let's do the Electoral College map, all right? I think that'll be interesting for everybody to listen to. Here are the states that I'm convinced Donald Trump will win. They're in red. There they are. Alaska, Idaho, Montana, Wyoming, Utah, Arizona. Now, Arizona has been in play. It's gone back and forth. But my information says that internal polling in both parties, this, again, internal polling is polling you don't see. This is paid for by the political parties, shows that Trump has got out in front now by a healthy margin. So Arizona, I'm going to put in a Trump category. North Dakota, South Dakota, Nebraska, Kansas, Oklahoma, Texas. I never thought Texas was in play. They have a Republican governor, Republican lieutenant governor. The structure is Republican. Yes, Harris County, Houston, and Dallas will vote for Biden, and so will the border counties, but that's not going to override the other people. So I have it in the Trump category. Iowa, according to Des Moines Register, which is an honest newspaper, it's broken for Trump fairly significantly. All right, that was in play. And it looks like Joni Ernst, the senator, Republican senator, will win as well in Iowa. Missouri for Trump, Arkansas, Louisiana, Indiana, Ohio. Now, Ohio is a contested state. Joe Biden's going there today. But internal polling says Ohio favors Donald Trump at this point. Not a lock, but I have it in the Trump category. Kentucky, Tennessee, Mississippi, Alabama, Georgia. Now, there's a state where the networks say, oh, it's going to be very close and this and that. I don't think so. Georgia is going to go for Trump by a couple of percentage points. Florida. Now, this is the most interesting. Come back to me for a minute on camera. This is very, very interesting. So Florida is it. If Trump loses Florida, it's over. Bye. Okay? That's the end. But the Hispanic vote is breaking for Donald Trump more than it did in the past. And there are many, many more registered Republicans in Florida than there were in the past. So a very high-ranking Trump official told me this morning, very early in the morning, we got Florida. That's a quote. Now, Donald Trump gave a speech there at midnight last night, Opa-locka, where I taught high school, by the way. There's an airport there. And I believe Florida will go for Trump. Now, you'll remember that 4 years ago, I had a big shootout with the late Charles Krauthammer over Florida. And Google that if you have some time. And I think that would be instructive for you. That's 29 electoral votes. South Carolina, Trump and Lindsey Graham will win. North Carolina, Trump. I don't know about Tillis, the Republican. I don't know about him. But North Carolina, I have in the Trump category. West Virginia, total it up, 259 votes for Trump. All right, let's go blue. We have, and there's 270 needed to win. All right. So 259 I have in the Trump camp. California, Oregon, Washington, Hawaii, Colorado, New Mexico, Wisconsin. I have Wisconsin going to Joe Biden. Trump is there today. Could be wrong, but all the internals look like Wisconsin going to go for Biden. Illinois, Virginia, Maryland, New Jersey, New York, Delaware, New Hampshire, Vermont, Maine, three electoral votes for Biden, one for Trump, the far north of the state. Massachusetts, Rhode Island, Connecticut, Washington, D.C., total 227 for Biden. So it's 259 Trump, 227 Biden, according to my calculations. That leaves 52 electoral votes in play. Now, here are the states. I'll tell you what, I just can't get through the barrier. Now, I can guess. I could do that, but I think that'd be a disservice to you. I just can't get through the barrier on these states. So Nevada, six electoral votes, is crazed because Las Vegas has been shut down. How's that going to affect the workers, the union workers who voted for Biden, voted for Hillary Clinton last time around? Nevada could go to Trump. Could happen. But there's a very strong Democrat machine in Nevada. Minnesota. The internals, the Trump internals say Minnesota's leaning to Biden, but the Trump people say a lot of Minnesotans furious about what happened in Minneapolis. and the George Floyd riots destroyed this city, and those people are going to vote Republican? I don't know. All right, Michigan's 16 electoral votes went to Trump last time, as you'll remember. This time, there's furious anger against the Democratic governor, Whitmer, because of the shutdown. And it's all about African-American votes in Detroit. Can Donald Trump go from 8% to 15% in the African-American precincts? If he does, he'll win Michigan. And so will Peters, the guy who's running for Senate, African-American. And then again, Pennsylvania. So let me give you the Pennsylvania polling, because this is vital. This is it. I believe whoever wins Pennsylvania will be the next president of the United States. We have a Susquehanna poll, 499 likely voters, 6% spread favoring the Democrats, 6%. Susquehanna has Trump 49%, Biden 48% in Pennsylvania, even with the 6% deficit in polling. Trafalgar, very favorable to Donald Trump. Okay, 1,062 likely voters in Pennsylvania. They don't give political affiliation at Trafalgar. I wish they did. Trump 48, Biden 46. So those two polls, Susquehanna and Trafalgar, have Trump winning Pennsylvania. Monmouth poll, that's a university in New Jersey, has 9% gap favoring Democrats in the poll. 502 likely voters. This poll is a fraud. And Monmouth College should be ashamed of itself. You don't go 9% up on one party. All right, in Pennsylvania, they have Biden 51, Trump 44. The poll's a fraud. I might have to eat my words on Wednesday, but to me, this is just awful. And then Rasmussen, favorable to Trump, has Biden 50, Trump 47, Trump losing in Pennsylvania. This is Rasmussen, favorable to Trump. It's a 5% spread. Democrats were polled at a rate of 42%, Republicans 37%. So I can't call who's going to be the next president. I can tell you I believe Donald Trump's in the lead right now. And if he wins Pennsylvania and Florida, he's in. Hey, Bill O'Reilly here. As you all know, the dollar is at a 10-year low, and November could spell real trouble. That's why I recommend you consider physical gold and silver, and the only company I do business with in this area is American Hartford Gold. You can call them right now. Make sure you tell them Bill O'Reilly sent you, and they'll give you a free gold coin on your first qualified order. Since I have been recommending American Hartford Gold, gold's up over 40%, silver over 60%. So please don't wait. Call them now, 877-444-GOLD-GOLD, 877-444-GOLD-GOLD, or text GOLD to 65532.